We shall now study about some dairy products that are prepared using microorganisms on a very large scale. Because all dairy products are an everyday requirement and a large scale industrial production of these is required. So microorganisms are used for the production of these various food items. So let us see what these dairy products are. The very first one is milk. Now, from milk, we prepare different types of other dairy items, like cheese is prepared, butter, cream is obtained from milk, kefir. Kefir is fermented milk similar to yogurt. I will be sharing with you one video on how kefir is prepared, but it is similar to yogurt, and another form of curd, we can say. And it is prepared by making use of kefir seeds, and it is mostly used in European countries. And yogurt. So all these are the various milk products which are prepared on a very large scale, and we are going to study about them. So milk forms the base of all these different items that we are preparing on a very large scale. Water content and acidity changes. So when milk is converted into all these different items, the water content and the acidity changes. Now, what changes take place during the formation of each of these items, we will be seeing it. Flavor, taste and texture are improved. So we know that cheese, butter, cream, curd, yogurt, all these have got different textures. So you are going to get different items which are going to have different textures. The taste is also different. And we can create various flavors by adding various other flavoring agents like ginger or garlic or various other flavoring agents can be added to them, and you can get a product of a desired flavor. So flavor, taste and texture are improved after milk is converted into various products. Cheese preparation needs fungi. So why and how cheese requires fungus for its preparation, that also we will study. Not all cheese require fungus, only a certain variety of cheese will require the fungus in its making process. Otherwise, most of the cheese, they do not need fungus, only a few varieties. So these dairy products we are going to study one by one. So here is the preparation for cheese, cream, yogurt are almost similar. We do it at home also. Cheese basically we do not prepare at home, we purchase it from outside, but curd we make. Yogurt is also generally not prepared at home because it requires certain bacteria, and that is what yogurt is different from curd. Curd is prepared at home by just adding a little bit of curd to milk, and then we allow it to set, and the milk is taken a slightly warmer because this increases the bacterial activity and the process of preparation of curd becomes faster. So a little quantity of curd, which we can even call it as inoculum, so that is added to milk, warm milk, and then it is kept for a few hours undisturbed, and then it sets into a solid form. So we are going to study the method of preparation of cheese, cream, yogurt, and they are all somewhat similar to each another. Yogurt is different from curd in the form that it makes use of certain bacteria. A certain bacteria are added to them so that you get the yogurt. So that makes curd different from yogurt. So what is done is pasteurized milk is taken. So milk is always pasteurized. The milk that we get at home is always pasteurized. That is, it is heated at a certain temperature so as to kill all the unwanted microbes. All unwanted microorganisms are killed during the process of pasteurization. So such milk is taken, and then it is fermented using lactobacilli. So it's a bacteria, and this bacteria is added to the milk so as to bring about fermentation. Now, due to addition of this lactobacilli, what happens is that the lactose sugar, that is a sugar that is present in milk, which is called as lactose. So this lactose sugar is converted into lactic acid. And due to this conversion of lactose to lactic acid, the milk proteins that are present, they are going to get coagulated. And coagulation means that is they get converted into solid form. So the water content is left behind, and what happens is that all the proteins they get together to give rise to a solid structure. So milk proteins get coagulated due to lactic acid, and compounds with taste and flavor are formed. So this is how the various food items are going to be prepared from it. That is milk. So the process is pasteurization of milk, fermentation that is brought about using the bacteria called lactobacilli, and this lactobacilli converts lactose to lactic acid, and the in presence of lactic acid, the proteins that are present in milk, they get converted into solid form, they get coagulated, and finally we get different compounds of different taste and flavor. So what we have studied here in this slide is just a generalized process through which milk goes when it is to be converted into some another product, that is pasteurization and fermentation using some bacteria, followed by the conversion of lactose sugar into lactic acid, and then finally the coagulation of the proteins. Now the proteins that are present in milk are casein and whey proteins. You must have seen that when we want to make paneer or cottage cheese out of milk, we add vinegar or citric acid or lemon juice to the milk, and then you find that all the solid portion separates and the water content is left behind. So that is what we call it as whey. So whey proteins and casein are the two main proteins that are present in milk, and casein comprises of about 80% of the proteins of the milk. So that is coagulation of the proteins that takes place, and finally compounds of different taste and flavor are obtained. So now we will be studying one by one how the various products are going to be prepared.